to everyone who watches this video. Today we are doing a knowledge transfer about custom word packager. It's a special tool which allows to package ready to fly Jenkins images as word files, as Docker images, or as Jenkins file runner images. And we have four contributors on the call: me, Rick, Sladen, and Christian. So just to provide some context, I forgot to share my screen, right? Okay, and just to provide some context, we have a number of Google Summer of Code projects this week here, and one of the projects is related to a custom Jenkins distribution build service. So basically a way to build Jenkins custom distributions and to share these definitions. And at the moment, this project wants to be based on a custom word packager. So this is the tool I'm presenting today so that the project team can get more information about how it's organized, because most likely we will need some patches in this tool. Just a second. But I haven't removed myself. Okay. Just to provide you some history, a custom word packager has actually started as a test tool. So we have a number of test frameworks in Jenkins, like Jenkins Test Harness. It's a unit and functional testing framework. Also Acceptance Test Harness, which is rather integration testing framework, which is based on the various technologies, including Selenium, Docker, and big test frameworks operate with Jenkins as a word file. So they are designed to basically start word file, do some configuration and get it running. And there was a long problem for us when we were developing pluggable storage and other components. We do a modification inside Jenkins. For example, we changed the configuration of the system, but we still want to run a standard test suite. So one of the ways was to just write a lot of code. But other way was to actually supply Jenkins word file as a black box, so that to embed all the configuration, all the plugins we needed right inside the distribution. And this is the way we have chosen, because it provides a lot of additional benefits for users. There was a blog post, which is I'm currently screen sharing, build your own Jenkins, introducing custom word Docker packager. So it has been published in 2018, right before Jenkins World. And this blog post basically summarizes how you could build it. So custom word packager is a tool which is driven by a single configuration file. This configuration file allows you to specify a word file you would like, a set of plugins. Also additional system properties you would like to define, and Groovy hooks or Jcast, which is Jenkins configuration as code plugin, and other more features. For example, for plugins, you can not only use released versions, you can also take versions from incremental repositories, like from pull requests. You can just build the component on your own using commit specification. And the custom word packager will produce a component for you. Same for word file. So here it's not documented, but actually you can also write components. Well, it's documented somewhere here, maybe in the demo. Actually, let's open the repository and I will show it there. Okay, so yeah, we have a custom word packager repository, and here we have a number of demos which can also help. And one of the demos is, for example, all latest core, which shows how you can override particular components in Jenkins. So, oh no, it uses Maven. So let's take this one. So here you can see that I use non-standard Jenkins core, where, for example, I write a remoting library, I write stepler by recent versions. So I can just build everything from master branches and have a kind of boilerplate for the entire Jenkins setup. And obviously I could test this boilerplate setup. So this is one of the purposes of this repository. What I have been referring, yeah, we have Jenkins test harness, we have acceptance test harness, and also we have plugin compatibility tester. So plugin compatibility test results a tool which basically allows to take a set of plugins and run their tests against each other and against the Jenkins core test units. So again, you can consume word files there, and that's why there is a lot of options for integration testing, because we actually use that in Jenkins test pipelines at the moment. So this is how it looks like from the interface part. Yes, you just define a single configuration. You can also define, for example, this is a demo for configuration as code. So here you have a number of plugins you installed. Yeah, all these demos are a bit obsolete. It would be great to update them, but they should work. And here, for example, we inject the configuration as code YAML. So you can inject it as text, but here you just take the directory with pass, and here, for example, his Cask YAML, which basically uses Jenkins configuration as code plugin to do some configuration. So here it's authorization strategy, it's security realm, list to users, and other configurations. And you can add more using the Jcask engine. Same for Groovy hooks, you just provide a pass and everything gets packaged directly into the Word file or in Docker image, so it can be redistributed as a part of the package. Okay, any questions before we start diving into the code?
No.
Okay, that's good.
Oh no. Yep.
Okay, so one disclaimer which I should make. Right now there is a custom work package 1.x bridge, and there is a 2.0 alpha where you plan we/me plan to do a lot of breaking changes in order to provide better configurations, etc. And I do not plan to release the final version of 2.0 until this summer is over. So if you need to change something in custom work packager during your JSOC project, you're not restricted by binary compatibility, by configuration compatibility, and we can apply more drastic changes. So I deliberately do not change that, and if you need to contribute something, this option is open. Okay. Just a second. Okay. Yeah. So let's go to the code then. How it's implemented? It's actually a multi-model Maven repository. We have just a few models here. So this models is main library, also CLI, because custom work package was initially designed to be used as library, as a CLI tool. And also it provides a Maven plugin, so you can include it into your Maven builds. We have Jenkins file runner test. It's basically a part of the Jenkins file runner test framework, which allows to do additional verification of the stability and to ensure that Jenkins file runner packaging is still operational, because it's a lot more challenging than standard packages because of many moving parts. The customer package can basically rebuild Jenkins file runner repository for every custom distribution. Okay. I'll open my IDE. Just a second. Why does it show Jenkins file runner? Okay. Because I opened the wrong repository, I guess. Tools, custom web packager. Okay. So it may need some time. Is the screen big enough for you?
Yes, it's big enough.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So yeah, it's still caching, so there might be some issues, but we can proceed. I'll firstly start from CLI tool, just to show you how the interface works. So in CLI tool, basically it's just two files. So first file defines a lot of CLI arguments. So for example, you can supply configuration, you can supply Maven settings. For example, if you want to use a mirror, like we do it on CI Jenkins IO, Then various temporary directories, versions to be set, etc., etc. There is also support for bill of materials. It's JEP309, I believe. So it's another YAML configuration format for defining plugins. We also support environment, mostly for bombs structure as well. And then you can install artifacts if you want during the build, and use custom update center if you want to download custom plugins. We'll talk about some of these options later, but yeah, it's just a configuration interface. The most of the configuration still comes from the config file, which I've shown you in the beginning. And the main file is actually pretty straightforward. It just processes all these options, creates a configuration for custom work packager, and then triggers that. If you take a look at the Maven plugin, it's basically the same. It just provides Maven plugin flavor, but basically it has two modules, one for packaging, another one for build, and basically all of them just pass configurations. So yeah, it's different code, but the logic is the same as in CLI. Let's go to our main repository. It's custom work packager library. So this library is basically the tool itself. This library is pretty big compared to other components. So what it has configuration. Configuration, you can see that there is a lot of files. Why is it done in such way? We use Snake YAML in order to do configuration mapping. So basically we define a number of these config classes, and then everything gets converted automatically to our objects. So that's why there is a structure. So here, this is our root element, for example. Here we define that we want some build settings, we want to define a package like version, etc. We want to specify a work config, we want to specify plugins, system properties, Groovy hooks, configuration as code. So basically what you have seen on the top level. And all of that expands to different YAML files, so you can see a lot of them here. There is also essentials YAML file, which has a bit different format. It's been used on CI Jenkins.io. It was started for Jenkins Evergreen testing. We still have some components which use this YAML format, but yeah, in principle, it's just a bunch of configurations. So what else do we have here? I think that we should start from the builder class. So builder class is actually a part of Jenkins file runner. And this class isn't pretty. So this class and this project, here what you can see that so builder it just takes config, how many code lines we have, just 300, so it's not that big. What it does actually build, it's the main method. So what it does, just takes configuration. We will need temporary directory because custom work packager creates a lot of files during the build. We use this repository. There we create build root. There we load some configuration files. So there are multiple ways to supply configurations. So the first way is to just packager config YAML. There is also bill of materials, and there is POM XML. So for example, what I do in my instances, I will open, for example, just a second, LibreCourse Jenkins server, which should be a good reference implementation. So here, if you take a look at packager config, you can see that there is no plugin definitions. Why? Because I actually supplied it through POM XML, and POM XML is managed by Dependabot and other tools. So here you can see that there are dependencies supplied by Jenkins plugin BOM. So yeah, I don't really manage dependencies here as well, except a few ones. Yeah, this file fits the configuration in my case. But the default way is to actually use package config. And right now in custom work package 1.x, you can actually stack only one way of supplying plugins. You can supply them from both YAML files and POM XMLs. You can do overrides and other things. So it's something in the scope for the next version. So after reading all of that stuff and after reading of default configuration, we defy this configuration. We mostly check that we have a way to retrieve. Let me just show it to you. So yeah, basically we check whether Gcask plugin is installed, if Gcask section is supplied, and we could have more configurations, but right now we don't check that. So the logic is quite straightforward, and as developer tool, if you misconfigure something, most likely your instance wants to start up with awkward exceptions. So here what we do, we build core and plugins. Again, if no configuration, we just fail. Same for here. I'm not sure why it's not in verify config. And then we start preparing our environment. As I said, we can build components on demand, or we can retrieve components, for example, from PaaS instead of update centers. So here there is a logic which basically goes from these dependencies and builds them if needed, or copies them if needed using configurations. So it just prepares the environment. If you're curious how it happens internally, yes, there is a lot of Maven magic. But basically, custom work packager under the hood, it involves a lot of Maven things. So same for library patches. So here we just prepare all the built environment. And same for resources. For example, if you have Groovy scripts, if you have Jcask files, etc. Again, we extract these resources. Technically, we can build these resources or check out them from external repositories. Not all of the source options are supported right now, but it works. And what it produces, let me find a demo on this. I'm just trying to find something where we have produced built artifacts. So, yeah. Now it's a bit old. Okay, so basically we get so this code also doesn't build anything. Okay, so what happens if on these stages we just create all these artifacts, we cache them in Maven, and after that the next stage begins, where we actually generate a POM. So it's a pre-built POM. Pre-built POM means that it will actually define how we build the work file for our new instance, because we need to package everything inside. And here you can see that basically it's just another Maven POM XML. We code generate that. And here, for example, we include work file, we include plugins, which we want to inject. And after that, we just invoke a Maven HPI plugin, which produces a custom work. So it's the first stage of the build. That produces a work file, but this work file isn't ready for final consumption because we still need to update some patches. For example, we need to inject system properties. We need to inject everything in the config. So basically, you can see what happens here. So we take this pre-built work file, we explode that. So, and after that, we start replacing resources. So for example, we add system properties if they're configured. How we do that? We just modify a WebXML file inside of the configuration. So here, if you go to WebInf, you can see that there is WebXML file. And here we just do some modifications. So here you cannot see them because likely we didn't do it for this demo, but if needed, we will just inject additional entries in this file so that our configurations are applied. Just a second. Yeah, there is no example right now, but it just happens through the standard system properties engine. Do you have it? Yep. So yeah, I should have built at least one demo before the repository. Okay, let's try to build it. Meanwhile, do you have any questions or are you completely lost?
No, so far so good, I guess.
Okay. So for example, let's try to build the demo. Okay, so here, just make clean build. Again, Okay. So here's the work package in practice. So it's a CLI tool with a lot of Maven things. And hopefully you won't need to build anything for this demo. So here we just started this package and work right away. So we can just go to this repository and we can follow the build ideas. So here we took this package config. So we packaged everything into pre-built. Still builds other things. So it will take a while. Okay. So nothing is really fast here when you run on Windows with antivirus. When you run on Linux system or when you run in Docker, it's quite fast. But by default, it just produces insane amount of temporary files. So that if everything needs to be checked with antivirus, it's quite long. Okay. So let's go back. We have our file produced. So this is a file which was produced by for this demo, which we use for prepackaging. That here's our exploded Word file. And in this exploded Word file, let's take a look whether the configuration was overridden. Yeah. So in the bottom, you can see context param Jenkins install wizard. Obviously, when I was writing tool, I didn't bother to prettify XML. So it's something like that, but it works. So we just inject parameters and these parameters will be consumed by Jenkins engine so that on startup, it will consume them and they write system properties. Right now, this engine is available only to plugins, but in the recent weekly, we made it general API for plugins. So you can configure your plugins in the same way now. Okay, so we built our Word files and we can also take what else changed there. So for example, if you go to WebInf, you can see that we injected Jenkins YAMLD directly inside WebInf. So it's a resource within a Word file. If we had Groovy hooks, I guess we don't have Groovy hooks for this configuration. Yeah, we don't. We would have injected them into WebInf as well. So this basically produces our Word file, which is altered for execution. And after that, we will still need to build this file again because we need to package this Word file into a single distribution. So let's go back to our builder code. Okay. So, there is a lot of logic here, but basically we hit something like that. So you may also see that we also also produce a BOM file. Right now, it's not really needed, I guess. Where do we put it actually? I think we put it. Okay. So, yeah, here's our BOM YAML file. So basically, it's a JEP format which includes configurations and plugin we would like to include. You can see that this BOM format is a bit messy. So, for example, the plugin installation manager tool has a better definition. So, in the future, I would rather prefer to generate formats which are close to plugin installation manager tool. But still, it kind of works. So, what else happened in this phase? Actually, nothing specific. Then we built Docker if needed. Docker is also a default functionality. And for Docker, yeah, there is a lot of magic, but basically we code to generate a Docker file. So here's a Docker file. Again, nothing pretty here right now, because in this Docker file, we just need to write a work file by our produced test example. So it's easy and it's quite straightforward. And after that, you have options to either keep these files as is. For example, if you run inside Docker, you cannot just build Docker inside Docker. But if you want, you can actually build it locally. So for example, this demo actually runs the build. So if you open my build log, you can see that actually the script also invoked Docker build and produced the final image for me. So yeah, right now there is nothing really complicated there. So if you open the code, you can see that there is Docker file, it just passes the work file, and actually that's it. So, and it takes the work file and injects it inside. It's not that good for performance. It would be better to unpack everything. We do it for Jenkins file runner, but right now we do not do it for Jenkins work because we follow the standard format. In the future, we could do much better here. Okay, so let's try to launch this demo if you wish. So, do we have something? Okay, so yeah, basically, if you take a look at the Docker file, it's just runs it. So nothing really interesting. I won't even spend time. But yeah, this is the idea. We can inject code directly into a Word file, so that Word file is redistributable. And then for Docker images, we keep updating that, so that again, you get a Docker image with everything embedded. It's a bit more complicated for Jenkins file runner. So for Jenkins file runner, it's not enough to just add components. Because Jenkins file runner manages extension points. It also has some caches, and it will have more caches to speed up the startup. So long story short, the repository needs full rebuild. So when you build with Jenkins file runner, just a second, here you have a demo for Jenkins file runner. I want to launch it. So here you can see that we actually specify not only Docker base, we also specify Jenkins file runner base. But again, it will rebuild the repository entirely by overriding properties, etc. So if you're familiar with plugin compatibility tester code, it's approximately the same. So here, it just creates settings, it injects the configurations, it sets additional options for Maven build, it generates the image, then it generates a Docker file and again builds it. Just a second. Actually, I can show it. No, I cannot because files are not persisted here. But here you can see some examples. For example, this is a checked out repository for that and for output target. Yeah, there is basically Jenkins file runner produced as a build. So if you want, I can launch it later, but yeah, right now it's out of the context. I'd say it will just produce a binary or a Docker image. And this flow is actually outdated significantly because right now there is ongoing work on Jenkins file runner. So for example, last time I modified the flow, it was around 1 year ago. And after that, we introduced a number of features, including quick Docker packaging, including better layout, including vanilla images and dependency management. So most likely custom web packager needs a significant update to be effective for Jenkins File Runner, but it's technically doable. Yeah, if you wish to try, you're welcome to do that. I know that Rick uses both custom web packager and Jenkins File Runner in his CLI. So maybe you have already hit some issues, and if you want to contribute something, more than welcome. I spent a significant part of the last months on recovering the Jenkins File Runner build flow, which was a bit abandoned. Okay, let's go back to custom web packager. Any questions, any additional information I could provide to simplify your project?
So I'm guessing that this would be included as a library, right, inside the custom distribution service, because we don't just the YAML file, and we can just do configuration.builder and then provide the YAML file generation.
Yeah. Yeah. So it means it would be used as CLI. In addition to CLI, we have Docker packaging for Jenkins File Runner. So here, just a second, packaging the Docker builder. So basically it packages Jenkins File Runner, custom web packager in the Docker. It also offers some additional configurations. This image can build you Word files and source Docker files. It doesn't really build anything inside. In addition to that, just a second, in this Docker file. So here you can see that basically we inject a custom web packager. We have entry point, which is its CLI. So the usage is quite straightforward. You just pass it as a volume. Just a second. Should be in documentation, I guess. Or maybe not. I was pretty sure that it's actually in the documentation. Just a second. No, actually, the usage in Docker is not documented right now, but it pretty much is the same. You just need to pass volumes to right place, and then the tool will build the image for you. Mm-hmm. So if it helps in your environment, instead of using custom web packager as a CLI tool, you could use it as Docker image, but in principle it's your choice. It doesn't have too many advantages on its own.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So what else could I do for you?
Yeah. Oh, one more question I would ask was that would we be making any, I think Greg raised this question in the previous meeting which we had. So once I download the WAR file, I cannot make any changes to the versions or the plugins, and they cannot be upgraded. So I think Rick, if you could elaborate more on that, or is that enough? So is there any workaround for that?
Yes, I want to bring this solution to my business, so my team, but we hope that the bundle, the plugins can be upgraded. Maybe we can support the feature, or maybe we can put those plugins not as a bundle of the plugins. So do you have any thoughts about this, Olga?
Yeah, so let me just show you one of the repositories. Yeah, let's just go to the repository of what we've shown today, CI server. So here we use dependabot. So dependabot is used to update these dependencies. But first of all, number of dependencies is going to shrink because we move everything to bill of materials. So hopefully I won't need to manage the config too much. And another thing that in the future, we may not need dependabot for that at all. So why I use dependabot? Because I just cheat and I use existing tool. If a plugin installation manager supports updates on its own, then you just won't need that. You can create your flow without dependabot, without similar tools, just by using plugin installation manager tool, which can show updates right now. But it's quite trivial to create a code which would submit patches. And for example, I already did Maven plugin for incremental versions. So for incremental versions right now, you can just use invoke Maven plugin and it will update versions in your plugins .txt. Well, it's not a rocket science. We can create something like that for YAML files and to use it efficiently. So you don't really have to use POM XML in order to implement plugin updates.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It was just a bit convenient for me. It's useful, for example, in this particular case. Because I use this POM XML not only for custom work packaging, I also use it for development. And because this repository is largely configured with Groovy hooks. So for example, you can see scripts, etc. And the magic here that in scripts is actually a Maven submodel. So when I open this project in IDE, I get automatic syntax highlighting, auto completion, etc. for Groovy hook development in Jenkins. And moreover, I can even debug these hooks. So that's why in this repository, I will likely stay with POM XML approach. But in general, it's your choice.
Okay, cool. So once we have the YAML file, we can. You're saying that we can develop a tool maybe to just update the YAML file of whatever plugin versions are there. Yes. As and when the plugin updates become available. Okay.
Yes, there is a lot of tools which allow patching YAML files. For example, Olivier created a tool for Jenkins infrastructure. So now if you go to infra CLI, well, for example, Jenkins infra repositories. There is a lot of YAMLs there, and these YAMLs automatically updated using the tool created by Olivia. So
okay.
It's just a matter of coding.
Okay, sounds good. Mm-hmm. So do you foresee any patches being made to custom work packager for this project, or is it to use as is?
I don't know. So it really depends on what you need. Mm-hmm. Because, for example, if you want to add theme management,
then we
will likely need to support something like that in custom work packager. Mm-hmm. For example, we can check whether a simple theme plugin exists, and if yes, put files to proper locations. Mm-hmm. Same we could do for pipeline libraries. So pipeline libraries could be also integrated into bundle so that you get configuration as code. Right now I do it manually on my instances, but it would be cool if it was a part of custom work packager. So for example, if in your custom Jenkins distribution service, you support managing pipeline libraries, mm-hmm. then again, it could be a good option for you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's cool. Yeah, those were my questions from my end. I'm good.
Rick, listening?
Not from me.
Yep, me either.
Yeah, so If you want to see more examples how custom web packager manages repositories, so for example, there is CI Jenkins IO runner. It's a repository for Jenkins file runner packaged by a custom web packager. And most likely right now it needs a serious update because I haven't touched it for a while. And I plan to update it, but in principle, it should work and you can see how it's used in practice. So for example, there is pipeline libraries, so there are Groovy hooks, and this instance basically try to emulate CI Jenkins IO as Jenkins file runner. And then it also uses POM XML, so it's not really aligned if you ask me about plugin versions. Just pulls the latest versions, and this repository hasn't been migrated to bill of materials yet. I guess it's my next stop. Okay. Yeah, this is an up-bounce disaster. Okay. It's pretty like much like that. So, if you need to make any patches in custom work packager, again, I leave all options for compatibility breaking changes open. I'm not sure how much time will I have to work on custom work packager on my own, but maybe I will be doing something mostly in the scope of Jenkins file runner because I want to improve the flow in order to improve performance of Jenkins file runner. Okay. Anything else for today?
Not that I can think of.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, so hopefully it provides you enough information. If not, I will try to periodically join the meetings and I'm available in chats.
Yes, definitely. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, then I will just stop the recording and I will publish this video maybe tonight. Then, Sladen, if you did notes, you're welcome to contribute some patches to the repository's documentation. Definitely. So that we can keep it up to date. Okay, that's it.
Okay. Thank you, Oligo.
Yeah, thanks, everyone.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks.
Yeah. Bye.
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 Yeah.